I wish I had more time in the day. Just know if I had it my way, you would be priority, not sacrifice. But right now I'm caught up in this way of life, way of life, way of life, to make sure that my future right, future right, future right. Hold me down, the payoff coming. Ooh, why I always feel like I'm on the time limit, fucking moonlight all in my
business. Yo, yo, yo. It's been a good minute, yo. It's been a while. A lot has happened since the last time. The last time I was up here, it was with my two schoolmates, and we discussed Donda and that thing going on with Drake and all that stuff. But now it's a new year. It's a whole new year. It's a new podcast season. You know? You know, let's get straight to it, bro. Like I never left. Anyway. Yo, yo, yo. Hey, yo, welcome back to the King and Vibes, the podcast. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey. Let's go ahead with like everything, bro. First thing first, man. My podcast and stuff, my podcast will no longer be on Spotify and all that stuff for right now until further notice. Reasons for that is the reason why I no longer have any of that stuff on Spotify and stuff. They now will be on YouTube with my King and Vibes channel, and they will be on my website, which I think, I don't remember, but I think I might have mentioned on one of the other podcasts that I had put my website down, but now it's back up. I don't remember if I told y'all that or that, but it's up now, and it's as far as I know, it's gonna be up there for a while. But yeah, there's gonna be a podcast section where all my other podcasts up there, and you can watch it. You can either go to my website and watch the podcast, or you can go onto our YouTube and watch the podcast. Any of the old ones and the new one right here. That's one thing. Like I said, it's a new year, bro. It's January the 16th, 2022. Let's just thank God that we made it to another year, man, and hopefully let's pray that we make it to the next one, you know? We lost a lot of people last year. We're still in this pandemic. Well, I mean, like, yeah, we're still in a pandemic. People don't treat it like it, but I mean, technically, we still are. COVID then got like 3 new updates: the Delta, and the whatever Omicron. Like this damn thing been dropping DLCs like a damn game, bro. I'm like, but I've been dodging for 2 years now? Yeah, I've been dodging it for 2 years. As far as I know, I haven't caught it. As far as I know, because you know sometimes you can't catch it, not even freaking know it. But as to my knowledge, I'm still one of the ones that haven't caught it yet. Knock on wood, and all that type stuff, man. Man, I thank God for that. I thank everybody keeping me safe and all that, man. But what else is for updates? Last year, it is the last year, y'all, of me being in school. For those who don't remember, I'm about to show y'all right now. It was supposed to be up before I started recording, but apparently it didn't. Full Sail. Yes, sir. This is my last year at Full Sail University. I graduate, hopefully, if I don't, you know, get pushed back or whatever, I might get pushed back, because I might take a break, I might take a month break sometime near the end, but, it's supposed to be still this year. I'm supposed to graduate this year, y'all. Hopefully, I'm praying on that, it doesn't change or whatever, but yes, this is my last year, and I should be getting my college degree, my bachelor's in music production, and you know, like when I applied for Full Sail, right, and I know that it was gonna be a 2-year college, and I was like, oh man, 2 years, I mean, like, that's usually, you know, college was like 4 years or whatever. I'm like, man, that's cool, 2 years. Do my thing. It probably might even feel like 2 years. But nah, bro, like, this 2 years went by fast. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. And I'm mad because I don't think I got the full experience like I really wanted to. Like, and it's nobody's fault because it's this COVID thing, man. Like, the first year, I was doing stuff online, bro. And like I said, I got on my past podcast, we've been on campus for a while now. Excuse me. Except I'm not on campus right now. I'm online right just because of the classes online. But we're on campus right now. And you know, I just feel like I didn't get the full experience that I wanted to. And it's nobody's fault. It's not. I don't blame Full Sail for it. I don't blame anybody for it. You can't blame anybody for it, you know, because it's a thing that happened, and so, you know, you stuck with it, and you just had to live past it. I just wanted like a little bit of, you know, I guess quote unquote college experience, even though I go to a school that's not really like where you go to get your college experience, and I knew that. Don't get me wrong, I already knew that I was coming to a college that it was about putting in the work, putting in, you know, because you out here trying to start a career. I already knew that, y'all. But I still want to collaborate, you know. I still want to meet new people, and I did that. I'm not gonna lie, I did that. I met a few people. We did something. We did some music. We did some stuff. You know, hung out and all that stuff. And I did that. And I'm grateful that I was able to do stuff like that. I might just be being greedy and just was like, I wish I would have done more, you know? But, you know, it's life, you know? I'm only 20, so, like, and that's the thing about me, y'all. I be feeling like my life is on the, like, a clock. And the thing is, though, it's like, I feel like my life is on a clock, but the clock is invisible to me, so I never know, like, what time that clock is. I never know what time, how much time I have left. And so I'm always trying to rush things, always trying to get experience, always trying to do things before that clock runs out. And like, if you look outside of me, it's like, yo, you're 20, bro. Like, you young as heck. Like, you know, I turned 21 this month. I mean, this year. And it's like, yo, you still young. You still got a lot of stuff. But at the same time, we don't know that, bro. Like, we don't know when our time is up. I can never see 30. I can never see 25. I can never see 21, to be honest with you. Just keeping it butt, like, I'm keeping it mad real with y'all, bro. Like, that's why I was saying I feel like I have a clock, a time limit, but it's invisible and I can't see it. But I know that clock is running down. I just don't know how much I have left. You know what I'm saying? And so I try to, like, and that's why I'm like, I wish I would have did more college stuff. I wish I could have had more experience. But, you know, looking at an outside point, I am only 20. So hopefully and praying I do get that experience when I, you know, maybe sometime in the future or whatever. Sorry to get real on y'all real quick, but I know this is a place for anybody to cool, to chill, whatever. Sometimes you gotta be real, man. But what else is new? Oh, I'm back on my songwriting, and I'm planning this thing right now. I'm getting this thing together where I'm going to get a bunch of artists. I'm gonna write the songs because I'm a songwriter, and I'm making the beats and I'm writing the songs, and I want the chosen. I don't know how many people I'm choosing because I do not know how many songs I'm going to do. And at the same time, they're not doing it for free. I'm paying people. And, you know, when you're out here trying to do things, when you're singing and you want to do that for your, you know, life or whatever, you got pay people, and that's fine with me. Some of y'all don't understand. Some people want beats, bro, and they don't even want to pay your guy, bro. Like, they just want the beats for free. And I'm like, bro, I'm out here trying to do this for a profession, bro. You got to pay. But, yeah. Because I got to pay people, so I don't know how, you know, the better quality of the singer or whatever, the more you got to pay, which is reasonable. Like, that's all reasonable. But The reason why I can't tell y'all how many songs I'm gonna have on there is because I don't know how much the cost is for everybody together. But I do know I want at least, I want to say the minimum is 3, but the maximum is 5. You know what I mean? The maximum is 5 people, but the minimum is 3. You know, I'm putting a little project together, and I want at least 3 people, but I really want 5 people. You know what I mean? Yeah. But yeah, it's gonna, I'm writing the songs. I'm making the beats. I can't tell you what's the vibe of the thing gonna be yet. You know, I'm still trying to get back in this creative mood, bro. Last month was crazy for everybody I knew in the creative field. Like, everybody was, like, drained mentally. I think that was because of school. But I feel better now, y'all. And I think it was because of the class I was in. But, man, thank God I'm out of that class, boy. I'm out of it. Ain't no more of that. Ain't no more of that. I'm done with that class. I am not seeing that class no more. No more. But, yeah, y'all. I'm trying to get back on it, y'all. And it's kind of been a little bit difficult for the songwriting part because if for those who don't know, I used to rap. You probably can't find any of my rap songs anymore because I took them down because I realized how much of an ass rapper I was. But I really you can't find one song on Spotify, which is Prince Vegeta, which I don't care what anybody says. That's the best song I ever put out, and I think it's amazing. To this day, I still think it's amazing. Going through ear training and all that stuff at school, I still think that song is pretty good coming from me. And my boy Bullet, he was on it too. He did a good job on that too. But since then, like since I stopped rapping, I haven't wrote songs a lot. So it's kind of like hard getting back in that creative space when I'm writing songs. I wrote a few songs starting in school. I wrote a song for my class. And then I wrote another song because I wanted to do open mic night, but I never did it. And that's another thing I want to talk to you all about. Like, we've been having open mic nights around here, and I haven't really performed that much around here, and I really want to. I really want to perform one of my songs, even though I don't rap. It's like a poetry type stuff, man. It's not really me trying to rap like I'm a gangster or something, but it's like a poetry, you know. That's what I'm trying to do. But I haven't performed in front of people in such a long time, and I don't know, man. It's a lot on me, and I'm trying to get over that because I really want to do that. But yeah, so it's been songwriting. Getting back in songwriting has been a little bit difficult for me. I just got to get in my space, you know. I just have to have the, you know, I just got to get in my space. I know that's what it is. And I just haven't been in there yet. And then once I finish the beats I want people to rap or sing on, I'll start writing the songs and I'll have that out. New year usually means a new King Amp Vibes volume. And I do not know if one's going to come out this year. That's crazy, right? That's crazy, right? I do not know. I don't know if I'm even going to continue it, to be honest with you. I might not, y'all. I might not. Because we're on 4 right now. We're on King. The last one was last year. And it was King Ant Volumes 4. Yeah, it was King Ant Volumes 4 or 3. You know, I put out so much stuff, I low-key forget myself. But yeah, man, I don't know if a King Ant Volume 5 is going to come out this month. And the reason why is because of that project I'm talking about. I don't know, man. I want to get in my space, but at the same time, I got so much stuff, ideas in my head. I just don't know what time I should, like, put them out, you know? And, like, King Ant, I want to keep the tradition. Usually the tradition is the King Ant Volumes usually come out in, like, the few beginning of the new year, you know? That's how they usually do. So if I don't put it out in the beginning of this new year, I'm not going to put it out later. You know what I mean? I don't know. I might skip this year. Who knows? I might do it. You know? Skip a year. Skip a, you know, King Ant Volume 5 can wait. And then, you know, I'll grow. Get some skills up and then put them back in next year, you know? 2023, y'all. But, yeah. Is that it for the intro and update? I do not remember if I had anything else to say. Yeah, I think that's it. But let's go ahead and get started on what today's podcast is on. I don't know if I said this, but this is now season 3. And the reason why is, and the last season of King Ant on the podcast, it was only 3 episodes. And the reason why I just skipped over to season 3 is because, you know, it's been like a while, bro. Like, the last one was in like November, I think, or August or something like that. One of my new things I want to do is keep up with the podcast. Because I do really like doing these. I really do. And I hope other people do enjoy watching them. You know, I don't know if I sound interesting to y'all. I don't know if what I talk about is interesting to y'all. I try to make it interesting. Some people don't listen to me just because they know me and just don't want to see me grow in like what I do. You know, and some people just don't have a patience for podcasts and stuff like that. But I just want to get connected to the podcast community and, you know, just find and just entertain people. You know, that's what I'm trying to do. And I really do like doing this. I like the whole process. I like the vibes. And I just like having I just like having a thing that's me, you know. I just like having a thing that's me, you know. So I'm going to keep doing podcasts until I don't do podcasts. And if I ever stop doing podcasts, it's not because of y'all. It's just because I just stopped, you know. But let's go ahead and get to what today's topic is. It's going to be a short podcast. It's been such a long time. I have ideas. I just don't want to run them all up in this one podcast because I might have other people on here. So let's go ahead and get started on. Oh, wait, before we do that. Before we do that, I do have a lost episode. I did a podcast with the boys about the Donda and stuff. It was supposed to be a part 2. I ended up losing that. I don't know if I still have it. I don't know. If I ever do find it, I'll just pop it up on my channel and I'll put it on YouTube. There's no recording. There's just audio. There's no video. There's just audio. So if I ever do find that video, I'll definitely pop it up. It's a Donda and CLB part 2 versus. But yeah, it's just a lost episode. If I ever find it, I find it. If I don't, then it's just gone. And we just had a good discussion among friends, whatever. I can't talk. Sorry, y'all. All right, but now back to what I've been trying to say. Like, things keep popping in my head. The topic for today is going to be. My favorite songwriters that I feel like are very good songwriters, and I just feel like they just like touch me in their lyrics. Their music is like the beat choice and all that stuff is excellent. But excuse me, y'all, man. But I really would just want y'all to focus on the lyrics. And so let's get started. So the first person I want to talk about right now is let's get this one out the way. Have y'all seen the new movie Encanto on Disney, right? It's a great movie. I loved it. But the reason why I'm talking about it is because of the music, right? Obviously. Even though I say obviously because it's a music podcast, but I have some ideas popping up that I will slowly move away from that. I mean, it's still going to be music, but we're probably going to get into some games and stuff like that, you know. But anyway, I really want to talk about the music. First of all, because I said that, don't take away from the actual story. The actual story is fire. This movie is fire, bro. The music is fire, too. That's why we're talking about it. And the music was written by this man right here, wherever, which way I popped it up. Because now, like I said before, y'all, this is not Spotify, only on YouTube. So I can do effects. I don't do that much effects. But I can do some little edits. But wherever I put the freaking picture of him, this is, all of the songs were written by Lin. I don't want to say his resident name because I can't pronounce it. But y'all know Lin. Some of y'all know Lin. Lin is the man from Hamilton, all right? The musical. My grandmother loves that. I never watched it, you know, so before. But I didn't know Lin wrote most of the songs. I'm pretty sure. I don't know if he wrote all the songs, but I knew he wrote some songs for Moana, which is another fire Disney movie. I went to go see Moana, like, I think twice or maybe 3 times when it came out. Moana was fire. I seen Encanto twice now. That movie's fire. The music in Moana was fire. In this movie, the music in this, bro, it was fire. Let me tell you. But the two songs in that Encanto movie, right, that stand out to me the most, lyric-wise and instrumental-wise, is Pressure. And We Don't Talk About Bruno. Some of y'all, if y'all seen that movie, y'all knew that song was gonna come up, bro. If y'all ever, for the people who haven't seen that movie, you gotta go watch it. Because if you haven't, you're not really gonna, like, really get the feel of what we're talking about right now. But, I have to set Pressure away because I'm only really going by to talk about the Bruno song. Pressure is a good song. I love it. But the Bruno song, right? That song was number one trending for, like, I think some few weeks. And I do not... I want to play a little bit of it. And I think I will. But this is YouTube, so we have to be careful. I don't want to get copyright. But, the song is amazing, bro. The lyrics are amazing. The music itself is amazing. I've been listening to this song for a while now, bro. And I had watched a video, and I said that Lin, to get the feel of I think it's Colombia. I think that's where it's taking place. I could be wrong, like I'm always are, but I think it's Colombia, and he went to go, you know, get a feel of Colombian music. And I just want to, like, take a moment to, like, some people might not understand. People who don't make music is like, yo, like, how can going to a place, like, help you get a feel of a music, bro? You can just, like, listen to it on YouTube or whatever. And that's not true, bro. That's not true at all. Because I experienced that too myself, because I've been on a cruise and I went to the Bahamas once, and I came back and made this cool, it's a song called Mellow Out. I don't know if it's on my website or not, but if it's not, I'll put it out there right now after I'm done with this. But I made Mellow Out, and it's one of my cool, chill reggae type jump, bro. I'm pretty sure it was the cruise I went to Jamaica on after I got back from that one. I made that beat. And just going to a place and, like, taking it in and seeing the sight, listen to the music, go to all these places, bro. Travel, right? Traveling. You're taking some of that with you, bro. Especially as a creator. You're going to take that with you and put it into what you work on. But there's an issue that happened with Bruno, and I want to talk about it real quick because I don't want to make this whole podcast about it, because I'm supposed to keep it for another one. But apparently, YoungBoy, NBA YoungBoy, had dropped like three songs, and two of those songs are top Bruno, and then Bruno was number three, and then the other song was number four. And that to me made me mad. Because, for a fact, I knew how much a musical, like, genius Lin is. And then I look at YoungBoy, and I'm like, half of the stuff you do is not even coming from you, bro. I'm pretty sure Bruno don't even write his own lyrics. I have no evidence to back that up whatsoever. But, you know, and it just... It makes me upset, really. It makes me upset because it's telling me where my generation is when it comes to creativity, bro. It shows that, like, y'all... I don't know, bro. I'm trying to choose my words wisely, bro. It shows, like, y'all just don't know nothing, bro. It shows that. And it shows how brainwashed y'all are, you know? Because, fuck it, this my shit. Niggas like YoungBoy, bro, there's been niggas like YoungBoy since hip-hop dropped. what YoungBoy talk about and rap about is shit that been said before, bro. Okay? I can pull up 5, 6, 10, 20, 50, 100 songs that's about the same shit YoungBoy rap about. Now, I hate when I talk about YoungBoy like this because niggas have the audacity to be like, yo, you a YoungBoy hair, whatever, whatever. I listen to the dude, bro. I listen to him. I just don't treat him like a damn god like y'all niggas do, bro. And when, okay, see, I said I wasn't going to make this whole podcast about YoungBoy. I'm not. I'm fucking not. Okay, I'm stopping right there. We're going to have this discussion another time, y'all, because I want to talk about these people. I can, if anybody remember, my first podcast was about YoungBoy. And I can see why people can, like, make a debate about, I hate that dude, bro. And I really don't. I hate y'all. I hate his fans. I don't hate him. I hate the fans. I really do. I'm going to stop talking about him. Because I go on a whole rant about him. But let's just move on to the next songwriter. Where's my list? Okay. Since we're talking about rappers, let's move on to, if anybody knows, this rapper named Montana of 300. He is a Chicago drill rapper. And like I said, we're not here to talk about, you know, the beat or whatever. We're here to talk about the lyrics. And as a person who you know, comes from hip hop, who loves hip hop, even though I love every genre, when it comes to hip hop and songwriting, Montana really is like, he really is a GOAT. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. So I'm a genius right now, y'all. So I'm gonna read some of y'all these lyrics from probably one of his most listened to song is Chirac, the Chirac remix. Just for y'all to like understand how like he writes his music, like how he write his raps. So I'm just gonna write like the first few lines of the verse, and you know. Look, I've been balling cause skip college. I'm a bad boy with that big papa. Let's stop right there. So, off rip, he already about to go in. You already he's about to go in. For those who's not a hip hop person, I understand this, but you gotta listen to the lyrics. I've been balling, coulda skipped college. Okay. So, for y'all who don't know, a lot of basketball players skip college because, you know, they were good at basketball and went straight to the NBA. And so, that's basically what he's saying, but he's not talking about basketball. He's talking about, you know, getting money and all that stuff. But then the next line, he says, I'm a bad boy with that big papa. Y'all know Biggie? y'all know Biggie. Biggie made a song, Big Papa. You know, I love him when you call me Big Papa. You know that song? And Big Papa can also be interpreted in this line right here as a gun. So, and Bad Boy was the record label that Biggie Smalls was signed to with Diddy and them, you know? So I'm a bad boy, like I'm a bad boy with that Big Papa. He's making a Biggie reference while also saying he's that nigga with a big ass gun. Okay? So off rip, he's already making references. And that's what Montana really like really is, bro. Like he really goes in to what he's rapping about. Let's see if I can find something else. But, you know, I just want to keep talking because I don't want to sit here in silence for y'all when I'm looking up. All my stuff aren't scripted, y'all. So, I'm not going to lie to y'all. I just come in here and start talking. Because not a lot of people be listening anyway. But listen, that man said, keep the green on me like a Jets jersey. I'm pretty sure I don't have to interpretate that. Y'all know what that means. To the opposition, I ain't never worried. Keep the dirty on me like I'm Stephen Curry. I'm pretty sure many rappers use that line. You know, Curry got the 30 on his back. 30 means gun. I can see you pussies like a mini skirt. Keep talking. You gonna get it first. And the toughest with you gonna get it worse. Now right there, just go hard. You know what I mean? Now go order up about 20 shirts. RP face on it. Had to show they ass how that semi work. Yeah, they got smoke April 21st. I ain't gonna lie. The flow of how he goes on this song is just is crazy, bro. It's just crazy, yo. Hoodie on like a monk. You know how the hoodies, you know how the monks be wearing their hoodies. I'm Boys in the Hood with that pump. If you've never seen the movie Boys in the Hood, you know, Ricky got shot with the pump shotgun. So that right there is already it's a lot of references, yo. Montana is the king of references in his songs. Just like I like to tell people, Lil Wayne is a reference, simile king. He's like to use like an ass a lot in his raps. Montana is the reference king, bro. He will reference anything under the sun, bro. But let's move on to another person, bro. Another favorite, one of my favorite songwriters I have is X. And I'm pretty sure y'all not surprised about that. I got an X tattoo on my right arm. And a lot of things about X is my favorite, bro. His lyrics, obviously, yeah. But his lyrics are... He's probably one of the ones up here that his lyrics are simple, but they make you think. You know what I mean? Like, his lyrics ain't something to dissect. But they make you think. Now, I can pull that up real quick. Like I said, I don't have these things pre-pulled. I can go to the most played one I X would probably be Sad. But I feel like Jocelyn Flores is probably one that I will go to. But we should probably pull up Sad then, since that's probably the one that y'all most likely know the most. So, as the chorus goes, who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. So, like I said, you don't have to really dissect what he's saying here and what's going on here, you know? I gave her everything. She took my heart and left me lonely. I think broken hearts contagious. I won't fix. I rather weep. I lost, then I'm found. But it's torture being in love. I love it when you're around, but I fucking hate when you leave, you know? But we all miss X, bro. We all miss X. For real. But, like, when X talk, we can feel his lyrics. And he was just one of the greats. And I often think about what would happen if he was still here and how much stuff would have gotten done, you know, while he's still here. You know, same with Juice, bro. Same thing with Juice, man. But Juice, I feel like Juice death could have been prevented. X could have been prevented too if he had security on him. But more Juice than X. And I blame his friends. And I think his mom not too long ago talked about it somewhere on some platform. I can't remember. It was a morning show or somewhere. But Juice friends weren't really his friends, bro. A lot of them could have helped him. A lot of them could have helped him. He was a drug addict. And as fans, you can't blame us. We listened to the music. We heard him talk about drugs a million times. But Juice ain't the first person to talk about drugs in the song. You know what I mean? So we didn't catch it. We didn't catch that. And I didn't catch that either. It wasn't until after his death until I started really listening to it. But it's nobody's fault. I can't really say it's his fault too. You gotta hold him accountable. But you also got to hold people around him accountable, too. You know what I mean? He got addicted to drugs somehow. Don't know when. It could have been before Fame. It could have been after Fame. It could have been during Fame. Well, it can't be after Fame. It could have been before Fame. It could have been during Fame. But somebody was supplying it to him. And he was off. He was obviously doing it around his friends, because you see videos and stuff of that. And his friends didn't stop. I heard he went to rehab one time and then he got right back on it. I'm pretty sure somebody probably got him right back on it when he went to rehab. And then, you know, what's that song with the music video where he was in rehab? He was talking in the circle. I forget the song was called. Drugs, shoulders. I forget with that one on my shoulder. I forget what the song was called. Lean with me. Right, Lean With Me music video was him in a rehab circle. We think about that now that he's dead, but during, like, you know, we weren't thinking about it. And it makes me sad. But I couldn't, even if I caught on it, I couldn't call him up and be like, bro, you okay? So I don't put myself on it that much. I don't put myself down that much for not, like, listen to this thing, but it's, and this dude was literally called out for help, and we just listened to it. Like, yeah, man, this shit slaps, man. This song lit. And while he's sitting here calling for help, I don't blame myself that much. But at the same time, like, I gotta be on it. Last person I'm gonna talk about is an artist that a lot of people y'all don't know. He's actually his song was playing in the beginning. He's my intro for this season. Is Rex. The song that I was playing was Time. I wish I had more time in the day. Just know if I had it my way, you would be priority, not sacrifice. But right now, I'm just working on this way of life. You know, just that right there, bro, like, hit you. Like, I know, it hits me. Especially now, you know? You know, Rex is underrated, most definitely. And I feel like he needs more attention, but at the same time, I'm scared that when he gets more attention, he'll change up. Example, I feel like Lil Nas, when he got more attention, his image changed. Billie Eilish, that's a great example. I was a fan of her, bro. I was a fan of her style, and I was a fan of, like, what she, like stood for and stuff, like, and that's how, like, cool she was, you know. But now, like, that she, you know, she blew up, obviously, like, everybody almost in the damn world know her. Not everybody, but, you know, she's up there now. And you know, she legal now. She turned 19, 18. I think she might be 20 now. I don't know. She's around my age, so I think she's 20. She's either 20 or 19. But now that she turned legal, right, I feel like her team is now pushing her, you know, pushing on the adult side. You know what I mean? Oh, that shit hurt. And I just don't, you know, that's not the Billy I, you know, fell in love with. That's not the reason why I was a fan of her and a fan of her music. I wasn't in for all, you know, the titty showing and all that other shit they got her doing, bro. I wasn't a fan of that. I was a fan of her music. I was a fan of what she talked about. And I fell off of listening to her, really. But like I said, I'm afraid for Rex because I don't want him to blow up and then he'll switch up. That's one of my biggest fears. But I'm pretty sure we're 39 minutes in, and I think that's going to be it for today. I'm not going for an hour. I have just easing back in to this podcast stuff. So, yeah, y'all, I'm going to have to catch y'all next time. Like I said, I'm going to try to keep up with the podcast. I got the, you know, the new project stuff I'm working on. I want to have guests, but you know how, well, half y'all probably don't know how, but, it's kind of hard for me. I hope y'all didn't hear. That's my roommate down there. It's hard trying to do a podcast in your apartment, in your room. I got burping again. I'm sorry. My God. Oof. But I'm going to try to have guests. We're going to talk about some things. Hopefully, it'll be exciting to y'all. And y'all enjoy it. All right. I'll catch y'all later. This has been the King Ant Vibes, the podcast. And King Ant signing out. Y'all have a great week, man. Peace.
I wish I had more time in the day. Just know if I had it my way, you would be priority, not sacrifice. But right now I'm caught up in this way of life, way of life, way of life, to make sure that my future right, future right, future right. Hold me down and pay off coming. Ooh, why I always feel like I'm on the time limit, fucking moonlight, all in my business.